connecting our lives through 5G.
It's all wireless companies can talk about.
5G, freaky fast, Randy.
5G's lightning fast speeds will change the world.
You can see them up the street. Boom, 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 every block.
But while they're ramping up anticipation, Miami-Dade County Commissioner Eileen Higgins says the 5G process has been anything but exciting.
It's been a bad rollout.
Commissioner Higgins gave me a tour of one Miami neighborhood, showing her disappointment.
This gives you an example of how much spray paint you'll have.
Because of the rush to install 5G before the Super Bowl, Higgins says spray paint litters the sidewalks. Poles are planted haphazardly, wires are dangling, and walkways are left sloppy or unrepaired.
We have no idea when or if they'll fix the sidewalk.
All over downtown Miami.
What we have here is telecom companies that are using this as an excuse.
Higgins says she's been fighting for months to get all of this fixed, and she thinks Southwest Florida is next.
At some point in time, they're going to come up with an excuse for the West Coast, like, oh, season is starting. We need to do it all now before everyone returns.
In 2017, a new state law forced communities to open their right-of-ways and utility poles to 5G equipment. Now, among other restrictions, cities and counties can't require companies to place equipment all on the same poles or use existing ones. Overall, they have little say on where companies install. The Florida League of Cities, including Naples, is suing the state over it.
We have to approve their permits in 30 days, even if we think the location is terrible.
But she says companies can blend 5G equipment into the community if they want to. It's on this building. Can you see it?
If we didn't know that was there, we would never have noticed it. It's perfect. So some companies are trying to install these in a neighborhood-sensitive way, and others, not so much.
Meanwhile, Naples and Collier County have done something Miami didn't. They outlined design standards, like requiring companies to camouflage 5G equipment. City traffic engineer Allison Bickett says so far it's been a smooth process.
They were very great as far as making modifications and submitting those back in.
Although no 5G equipment is up in Naples yet, Bickett says they're currently reviewing applications and drawing up plans. Higgins says she hopes the rest of Southwest Florida learns from Miami's mistakes and sets up design standards.
In our case, the city of Miami did not do a great job preparing, and we've gotten this.
And she wants the state to step in.
I don't think our legislators really knew how bad this was going to be on the street.